Hello, and you're very welcome to today's Study Travel newscast with myself, Charlotte Darrell.
And I'm Nicola Lutz. On today's show, our top stories are...
Tougher visa regime pledged in Conservative election manifesto.
Ireland approves draft legislation for international education mark.
Students at New Zealand business colleges displaced.
Here at home in the UK, the international education sector has become a divisive issue in the general election on the 8th of June.
Yes, the ruling Conservatives are promising tougher student visas and higher national health insurance fees for students. The party said that the students would remain in immigration statistics and repeated its pledge to reduce net migration to tens of thousands.
Alternatively, the Labour Party has promised to remove international students from the migration statistics. Labour has also said that it would remove tuition fees for domestic students, which currently would equate to a free tuition for EU students, although this could be subject to change in the Brexit negotiations.
James Pittman of Study Group said the government seemed to be implying that overstaying was an issue, but argued that the vast majority of students complied with the visas.
Across the Irish Sea, Ireland is pursuing an international education strategy. This week, the government has approved the draft outline of a new law that will introduce an international education mark for providers.
Education Minister Richard Bruton said that the mark was a significant part of the strategy and only schools meeting quality assurance procedures would be able to receive non-EU students.
The new draft law will allow institutes of technology to award their own degrees, give greater powers to industry regulator QQI, and include a new National Learner Protection Fund.
No doubt these measures will be well received by the quality providers, but it has taken a while, hasn't it?
Yes, you're right. The mark was originally supposed to take effect in 2015.
And speaking of regulators, over in New Zealand, international students at two business colleges are being transferred after the New Zealand Qualifications Authority, or NZQA, has flexed its muscles.
81 students at Linguists International Institute are being moved to an alternative provider after NZQA cancelled its registration due to serious concerns.
Also, New Zealand National College has voluntarily withdrawn its Level 5 and 6 business programmes after NZQA identified issues in an assessment requiring the transfer of more than 300 international students.
Grant Clinkham at NZQA said it would not tolerate poor quality education provision and takes action to ensure system integrity.
And now a roundup of some of the other news stories this week.
UK-based Oxford Royal Academy has announced expansion of its summer portfolio with the launch of a Young Learners course for students aged 8 to 12 and a programme for 19 to 25-year-olds.
International House World Organisation schools have seen a decrease in the general English courses, but a rise in the demand for specialist programmes. The association said this at its recent directors' conference, where I also gave a presentation.
Lila Liverpool has unveiled new online English programmes, as well as a junior digital academy course this summer, and a virtual fam trip for agents to share with students.
Sounds fun. Russian language provider Leiden & Den celebrated its 25th anniversary in style last week with a gala dinner in St. Petersburg and a fam trip around its centres. Happy anniversary to them. It looked like quite a night.
It did. We also had a celebration of our own at the Study Travel offices as director Stephen Roberts hit the big 5-0. Happy birthday, Stephen.
Yes, happy birthday. Also this week, Clarissa Waldron and Matthew Knott have been discovering the latest higher education trends at the British Council's Going Global event in London. Tune in next week to get the scoop on that.
That's all from us here today. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you. You can keep up to date with the latest Study Travel news stories at www.studytravel.network. Until then, goodbye.
Goodbye.